So this is analysis of LRDF section of exact that one. So let's get the sense of the paper first. If you see the paper, it's the first set question 1, 2, 3. There were 3 questions. So again, 6 days, 9 players. So too much of data is there. Hence, little bit of time taking. And honestly, it is a time-taking question, and keeping especially the 3 questions into consideration. But overall, this is a doable set. But just because it is time-taking, so one thing for sure, that this should not be the first set to be solved. Not be the among the first few set to be solved. But yes, it's up to person to person also, like whether you like this type of question or not. But yes, this is one of those questions that you could not have started with. You should not have started. Now this question 4 to 7. Again, this whole paper was full of data, like the 10 contestants, 3 events, lots of data is there. But the beauty of this set is the questions. There are some questions of this observation based and could be solved with little bit of effort. So there's 2 type of question. One, observation based, or you can solve just with a little bit of effort. That, like question number 4, it is purely observation based. With observation, you would have given the answer to this question. Question number 5, little bit tight, time taking but doable. And let's say if you solve 5th, 6th also is something that you can solve. Especially cannot be determined is one of the option. So 6th is very easy. Somebody who already got the exposure of this question from 5th question, so 6th is going to be easy. And 7th is again observation based. So that's why this is one set I would consider doable. So now the next set, that is 8 to 11. Lots of data, and lots of data, hence certainly time taking. So I would not suggest this should be one of the favorite set. It is moderate to difficult level, you can say. So, and especially, the chances of committing mistake is there if you are in a hurry. So guys, if you are solving this set just because it is theta type, then that may not be a right way to take reasonable sets. So in that case, this is again not one of my favorable sets in this particular paper. Now this one, 12 to 15. Again, lots of data. But one thing, if you can invest time once, it is one time investment to crack the set, then all questions can be done easily. Overall, I would consider it easy to moderate because data is there. So we cannot deny the fact that data is there. Now the 16 to 18, 16 is being very balanced set, 3 questions, doable, easy. Unless you don't have the problem with that. I don't have any exposure of this type of question. Otherwise, this is very doable question. 16 to 18 is one of those doable question. And best part about this paper, 19 to 22, I would consider it a difficult set. And we are fortunate that this is the last set. So obviously, this is one set that should not be tried in the test. For those of you who got stuck with this set, they could have saved their face by solving the last question. Last question, question number 22, was something that you could have solved easily compared to the rest of the 3 questions. So that should be the exit strategy. Let's say I got stuck with this particular set. And then I already invested lots of time. So in that case, I'm just scanning through the question, okay, which one question I can solve easily. The last question you could have solved. So guys, this is what the overall sense of the paper. So now, if I have to classify it, so topic distribution wise, as we saw that the first set, the math schedule for 6 days, again, LR question, 3 questions, moderate and time consuming. Again, 10 contestants, 3 events, again, easy to moderate, 4 questions were there. Ram Babu book reading, again, moderate to difficult, I would consider it. Then similarly, 24 questions, 4 subjects, easy to moderate, 4 predators, easy to moderate. Even if I am considering it easy, it is okay. Because just because few of the students may not have the exposure of this type of question, that's why I kept is easy to moderate. Mata powerhouse is certainly difficult. So that's why, on the basis of this, what I would consider the expected attempts as well as score and percentile. So easy to moderate 11 questions. Okay. Out of that, you would have easily solved 8 to 9 questions. Now, moderate to difficult, 4 questions, you can try solving 2 questions out of it or at least 3 questions also. Moderate but time consuming, 3 questions, again 0 to 1. Let's say if you are not trying this set, obviously 0. In case you got stuck and you want to solve one question, then one question was doable. And out of difficult 4 questions, let's say somebody got stuck and solving last question, that is also possible. So in that case, I would suggest, let's say, even if you're getting somewhere around 28, 29 marks, so you will be around 98% for 99.5, it is going to be something around 37. So again, say 3 more questions. And 80% around 15 questions. So overall, guys, this is one of those tests that is really going to give you new exposure, different type of sets, very good learning. So I hope after taking the test, whichever set you were not able to solve inside the paper, you analyze it properly, because that is very important, the best part as far as learning is concerned. So this is what I really want to talk about, this particular LRTI test. Thank you. Keep reading. Keep solving. Keep improving yourself. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to an analysis of the VARC sectional of EOM Exact CAT 1. What was the VA sectional like? Let's look at this. So 22 questions of the VA sectional, in keeping with the expectation of reduced number of questions from last year. The total time, of course, was 40 minutes. MCQ questions, there were 18, which also had negative marking. And the non-MCQ questions, 4 of them had no negative marking. Total number of RCs were 4. There were 2 RCs with 5 questions each and 2 RCs with 3 questions each. And this is where your major selection issue arises. Look at the length of each of these RCs. Your choice between the 2 RCs with 5 questions is a tough one, because both of them seem to have equal length, pretty similar length, 410 words and 440 words. Whereas the 2 RCs with 3 questions is one has a 250 word length, another has a 775 word length. And you will discover, or you will have discovered, that the one that has 250 words has very challenging questions. The 6 VA questions, 2 summary, 2 out of context, and 2 key in parajumbles. Let's examine all of these in detail and understand where were our easy questions, moderate, and difficult ones. So the one easy question, the lone easy question that we found was in RC4, that is question 15, the one that had to do with politics, the lengthy one, 775 words, which is an analysis of Obama's victory in the American presidential election and the challenges that lie ahead of him. The question was a specific detailed one and could be easily located. What were our moderate questions? The first RC offered us 2 moderate questions out of 5. The third question and the fourth one was to do with an inference, and the fourth was a specific detailed question. The passage itself was pretty heavy, to do with economic policy, the EFW report on the correlation between economic freedom, well-being, and poverty. So out of 5, 2 questions, easy. Our second RC, the one that had to do with environment, talking about geoengineering on a planetary scale to deal with a climate change crisis. The passage in itself was not heavy, not abstract, readable. But out of the 5 questions, it offered 2 moderate questions, that is question 9 and question 8. One was a logical continuation question, that was 9, and one a main idea question. Both of those were fairly easily identified. The options could be narrowed down. RC3, the one to do with public policy, offered us 1 moderate question. The short passage, the 250 word passage, that is question 11. The passage itself had to do with a proposal to make tax evasion a criminal offense. And this question had to do with an inference. RC4, two questions out of the three are marked moderate. And we saw that the first question, the easy one, was again from this passage. RC4, the one to do with politics and Obama's victory, has only three questions, lengthy passage, three questions, but you find that one is easy and the other two are moderate. One was a specific detailed question and the other is an inference. Highly, highly doable. If you got into this passage, perhaps even if you skimmed it quickly or even looked at the questions first, you could easily locate the answers because you find that two out of these three questions are specific detailed questions. So a quick skimming would have helped. Out of the two parajumbles, you find both are moderate. 17 and 18, both are moderate because the idea development is easily located. There are those repeated keywords with which you can link the sentences. Summary, out of the two summary questions, question 19, the one that is about 160 words long, is a fairly easy one, the one that talks about analog music and digital music, connoisseurs of music and what they relate to. Fairly easy because the main idea sentences are easy to locate, the language is moderate, the options are also not very tricky. You know, once you figure the main idea easily, you can narrow down the options easily, so moderate. Out of the two out of context question 22, the last one, which had to do with the stories that we relate to or how we get life lessons and life skills from stories. Fairly easy to read, the links are visible, and that one sentence that stands out, which moves beyond the scope, takes up a comparison between stories, reading stories and documentaries or some such thing, is clearly a main idea discontinuation and therefore is visible. You can, you know, easily get this right. Let's look at the difficult questions. So question RC1, question 1, 2 and 5, difficult. In fact, question 1, you can see that it's highlighted in red, was a very heavy one. You know, that inference that you are expected to draw from the first paragraph regarding the relationship between well-being and economic freedom and freedom or economic freedom. It's very difficult for you to narrow down the options. Every other option appears okay to you, or at least there are two other options that appear okay. But the focus of the question you should remember is the relationship between these two elements. So you cannot bring in a third component here like poverty and say poverty is what influences well-being and freedom. What exactly is the relationship between well-being and freedom? The relationship, that's what the question asks you. And therefore that only narrows down to that one option which refers to the relationship as a circular one. That is, one leads to the other and the other brings you back to the first one. So clearly the focus of the question should be understood. And that's what makes this a very challenging question. It's been marked a very difficult one. So our questions 2 and 5, the main idea question is not an easy one. There is also a specific detail question, which is quite challenging because it's very difficult, tricky to pick that detail. RC2, questions 6, 7, and 10, the assumption question, not highly difficult, but some of us have problems with identifying the right assumptions. Assumption in itself can be a difficult thing because you're looking for what is not stated and relating it exactly to the details that are stated, which means not an easy job. An assumption question in itself can be a difficult one. Some of you might have got this right. It's not an extremely difficult thing to identify the assumption here, but nevertheless, the nature of the question makes this difficult. A logical structure question, that is challenging, and an inference question, that is challenging. The logical structure being you know, the reference to the butterfly wings. Quite difficult, because for you to understand some of these words like aphorism, etc., could be difficult. So narrowing down to the correct answer is a challenge there. Passage 3, the public policy 1. You can see that there are two questions out of this that are difficult. Some of you might even have found them very difficult, because all the options seem to be worded similarly. The only difference is in the verbs there. And that's the entire thing. The verbs make all the difference. Close reading might help you. So if any of you went into this RC at the cost of the Obama RC, then you'd have to read the passage over and over. Maybe give it two readings. It's short, 250 words. You can easily give it multiple readings. Giving it multiple readings, understanding the connection between the terms, focusing on the verbs, the definite verbs and the probable ones, could be, might be, is, that's very important here. Otherwise, you'll definitely get question 12 and 13 wrong. 13 also is quite tricky, because it you know, changes that reason. The cause effect is very captured in different ways. So following the line of thought of because is very important. So very close. And if you thought that it's a short passage and can be easily done, you might have ended up spending a lot of time there. Next, the summary question, the difficult one, 110 words, something to talk about the Zeitgeist astronomy. The passage in itself is not very difficult to understand. You might even locate the main ideas, but the way in which the options are drafted, very close, very tricky. It looks like, you know, almost three options appear like they're trying to capture the main idea, you know, in different words. And to figure out what is missing or what the distortion in these options is very difficult. That's what will take you time here. And you might even, you know, get into this and eventually give it up, because it can be quite annoying to follow, to track the details. The one out of context question, that is 21, question 20, the one that has to do with acidity, looks so simple, you might even start with it. But when you get to reading it, every sentence appears to be so connected to acidity, and therefore seems to be, you know, everything seems to be connected. You don't know which one to eliminate. The thin line that differentiates, I think it's the first sentence that stands out there. The thin line that differentiates the out of context sentence is very difficult to identify. That's what makes this difficult. So these are our difficult ones. So that brings us to the decision making here. What should have been our choice? A very tough thing when it comes to the RCs. And 18 questions of RC is only 6 non-RC questions. Would I have taken RC1? Because it has an equal number of difficult questions. And the passage is also quite heavy for some of us not acquainted very well with economic jargon. This can be challenging. But then the word length is the same, the number of questions are the same, and eventually we've even discovered that, you know, both these RCs have 2 easy and 3 difficult questions. Environment one, again, you know, not a very difficult read, but some questions would really trap us. However, take one of these, we must, and probably 2 of these, you know, all those who are aspiring to a higher percentile, you're looking at a 95 percentile plus, or even 90 plus percentile, then targeting 3 RCs would be important, right? Which means your choice should largely be RC1, RC2, and RC4. In retrospect, many of you might have just not taken RC4 because of the length of it. But look at the nature of the questions. They are all fairly straightforward. You should have figured that a quick skimming, maybe a 2 minutes of skimming or 3 minutes of skimming, and then I look at the questions, scan for the answers, should have given me all 3 questions right. Okay, and then yes, I will get into RC 1 and 2, perhaps a 10, 12 minutes spent here, but maybe I might leave out 1 or 2 questions. Okay, if I'm good enough to, if I'm smart enough or sharp enough to understand that some of these are difficult, I might have let go of a couple of them. So out of these 13 questions, we are targeting of 3 RCs. maybe, you know, I let go of a 3 questions or a 2 questions, whatever. And then I clearly have 2 parajumbles, which I should have taken, 1 out of context and 1 summary. So 4 questions here and about a 10 questions of RCs. So we're looking at roughly a 13, 14 questions, which seems to be to take us to the highest percentile, 98 percentile and more. So this is where we stand with a 14 attempts and an 80% accuracy, which is roughly about a 2 or 3 questions incorrect. We're looking at a total score of 33 for our 98 percentile, because remember, we are targeting something like this, around the 14 questions, you know, taken from the various areas, the easy, moderate, and the difficult ones. So 33 gives us our 98 percentile, a score of 30, which is perhaps 13 attempts and an accuracy of 80%, gives us a score of 30, and that's our 95 percentile. 13 only, imagine, you know, time and less questions, fewer questions, gives you that much liberty to get into questions, read them carefully. So 13 questions is a highly doable thing here. You know, even if I pick 2 RCs, do them meticulously, and then, so let's say 2 RCs, either the 2 5-question ones or definitely that Obama one, it's 8 questions maybe, even if I drop a question or 2, 7 questions, and then I have maybe a 4 questions of the VA that I take, perhaps a question or 2 here and there more, right? 13 questions is a highly doable thing. Or even if I get into 3 RCs and drop a considerable number of questions, 3, 4 questions dropped or 5 questions dropped, and I take those easy VA questions. 13 questions with an 80% accuracy, I'm looking at 30 for a 95 percentile. 11 attempts with an 80% accuracy, a score of 27 gives me my 90 percentile. A score of 22, which is 9 attempts and an 80% accuracy, gives me a score of 22. And that's my 80 percentile. A 99 percentile is what I reach with a 36 odd marks, which is about 16 questions attempted. Perhaps I go wrong with three questions incorrect, and a score of 36. 100 percentile has very high standards, almost all questions done, 21 questions done, with 3 inaccurate gives me a score of 52, and that's my 100 percentile. So this is where we stand with regard to the VARC of Exact Cat 1. We hope you liked this sectional and you liked this paper and you found it extremely useful. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to the analysis of 2021 Exact Cat 1. We will be starting the analysis with the QA section. This is the usual flow in which we'll carry out the analysis. We start with topic distribution, followed by question mapping. We try to categorize the question into easy, moderate, or difficult. Based on our difficulty analysis, we try to reach expected attempts, and finally we attach scores to some key percentiles. Okay, so let us start with topic distribution. This was topic distribution for 2021 EOM Exact 1. 4 questions from linear equation, 2 questions each from profit and loss, time and work, and permutation and combination. And there was 1 question from percentage, numbers, surds and indices, ratio proportion, SICI, averages, time and distance, probability, progression, triangle, quartz polygons. And there was a question from calendar as well. Coming to the question mapping, let us first try to identify which questions in the paper were easy. So there was this question on linear equation, where a team was playing a T20 match, and there was some equation to be made with respect to the runs remaining with balls remaining. Okay, so it was given that initially the number of balls remaining are twice the number of runs required, but after a maiden over, the number of runs required become twice the number of balls remaining. So one can create a simple linear equation and solve this question. The next one was permutation and combination based question, where 11 identical objects were to be kept in 5 identical boxes. Now, distribution of identical objects into identical parts is always a tricky subject. But here, especially given the numbers are 11 and 11 objects, and there was one more condition given that each box should contain different number of object. Okay. So if you just try placing the random combination like 0 in the first one, 1 in the second, then 2, then 3, and then 4, you will realize that in 5 boxes, you would have already kept 10 objects. Okay. So the last object, the 11th object, has only one way to go. And therefore, the entire arrangement can be done in only one way. The next question was based on calculation of a particular angle, measure angle DBE inside a triangle. And this question can be easily solved by using a simple concept that angles opposite to equal sides are equal angles. So this is it. These were only 3 questions which I could identify as easy questions from this paper. Let us move to moderate level questions. This question was based on weighted average, where there were 11 samples of milk and water, the first one having the least possible concentration of milk, which can be taken as 0%, the last one having the maximum possible concentration of milk, which can be taken as 100%, and in between, the concentrations were in arithmetic progression. So one can take 10%, 20%, 30%, and so on. Okay, and these samples are to be taken in certain quantity, which is in the ratio of 0:1:2:3. Okay, so one can always multiply the quantity with concentration and find out the weighted average of concentration. So this was a simple concept. Our next question, based on simple interest compound interest, where 2 years simple interest was given as 5000, 2 years compound interest was given as 5500. So one can always distribute the SI and CAI among 2 years and calculate the rate of interest as well as the principal. And once you calculate the rate of interest and principal, calculating 3 years CI at the given rate can be an easy job. Next question on probability, where selection of at least one king or spade was to be made out of 3 cards, which can be selected out of 52. Okay, so there is a pack of 52 cards, you select 3 cards, and therefore the total number of selections can be 52C3. Okay, how do you get the favorable cases here, right? So you can take 1 minus not getting a king of spade. Okay, now not getting a king or spade, that means there will be 36 other cards and you need to select 3 cards out of those. Okay, so final answer can be 1 minus 36C3 upon 52C3. Then the calculation can follow. Next question was based on profit and loss, where a product was moving from A to B, then from B to C, C to D, and D to E. At every stage, there is some percentage profit or loss that is happening. So it was given that A is making 10% profit. Okay, B is losing as much as the profit made by A. Okay, that was given. Then C is making twice the profit than the profit made by B. And then D is making 15% profit over his cost. Finally, E ends up paying 5900 here. Okay, I think it was 6900. I'm sorry, it was 6900 that was paid by E. So how much does it cost to A? Okay, you can start this question by taking 100 rupees. Okay, and see how E is paying for that. Okay, so against A being 100, if E is spending 138, which is something that you'll eventually get once you solve it. Okay, so against A being 100, if E is 138 and if E is 6900, you can find out the quantity of the value of A through a simple equating process. Next question from Time and Work, where a question was based on alternate work that was to be done by 5 pipes A, B, C, D, E. 3 of the pipes that are A, C, and E have a positive flow rate, that is, they are the inlet pipe, and remaining 2 pipes B and D are the outlet pipes. Okay, so one can create a 5-minute cycle here. Okay, and find out how much water can be filled in those five minutes, and then we can repeat the number of cycles according to the standard approach. A question based on time and distance was there, where there were 2 cars A and B traveling between 2 cities, Delhi and Mumbai. It was given that A is taking 12 hours to complete the journey, while B is taking 18 hours to complete the journey. Now in such situation, we can always assume the distance, which can be the multiple of speed of A and B, time taken by A and B. So if A is taking 12 hours, B is taking 18 hours, you can assume the distance to be 36, and then you can solve the question using the normal process. The next question was based on ratio proportion, where the concept was based on each ratio or an addendum method. Okay, so two ratios were given and we had to add both the ratios, that is, numerator can be added and denominator can be added. This particular property is known as finding out the each ratio, or it is also known as addendum. Coming to question mapping of moderate and time consuming questions. So there was this question on time and work, where A and B were working alternately. It was given that if A starts first, the work can be done in 9 and 1 by 2 days, whereas if B is starting first, the work can be done in 9 and 1 by 2 days, okay, 1 by 5 days. So first 8 days work by A and B is same, okay. Now what you have to do is, you have to equate the 9th day's work plus 10th day's work in case 1 as well as in case 2, okay. So if A is starting first, then the 9th day belongs to B and the 10th day partially belongs to A, okay. And that can be equated to 9th day fully belonging to A and 10th day partially belonging to B. So if you equate this, if you equate the amount of work done in this manner, you will get the relation between efficiency of A and B. And once you derive the efficiency, you can always find out the time taken by A alone to complete the work. The next question was based on linear equation, wherein there was an age problem given, where A is telling B that I am 8 times as old as you were when I was as old as you are. Now, such kind of questions will always trick you with the language that they are using. And that's why this might be a time consuming question, because the students cannot directly understand the language here. The next question was based on permutation and combination. A 4-letter word was supposed to be made out of 8 letters of word endeavor. Now, one thing that you need to notice here is that there are two E's which are identical. Okay, so when you make 4-letter combination, there are two cases possible mainly. One is you include two identical letters and the remaining two are distinct. Okay, and find out the number of combinations and arrangement, because we are forming the word finally. Okay, so the number of arrangement need to be considered. Second case will be all 4 letters can be distinct, and in that case, how many arrangements can be formed. Next question was from progression, where there were two arithmetic progression which were to be added, and third series can be made. In the third series, it is given that the middle term square is equal to the product of the first and the last term. Now here one needs to realize that when you are adding two APs, the resultant is also an AP. So the third series that you are getting is an AP. Secondly, in the third series, if the middle term square is equal to the first and the last term, this means that the third series is a GP also. Okay. And if a particular series is an AP as well as GP, then all the terms are equal. But one really need to take a lot of time to understand this, and that is why I'm putting this question under a time consuming category. Our next question was based on profit and loss, wherein a shop was selling TV and washing machine at certain price. So TV was sold at a profit of 10%, washing machine was sold at a profit of at a loss of 2%, and overall there was a profit. Okay, so you can create one linear equation which is based on percentage terms, you can create another linear equation, and then you have to work with those equation. Now this question might get calculative, and that's why I'm putting it under time consuming category. Coming to question mapping of difficult questions. So there was this question on linear equation, where there were two equations given already, okay, and from the options we have to find out the third equation, which is independent of the first two. So one has to equate the determinant, and this might be a new concept to most of you, and that's why I'm putting it under a difficult question category. The next question was based on percentage, where A, B and C are giving chocolates to each other. So first, A is giving his 20% chocolates to either B or C. Okay, he can give it to anybody. He can distribute among B and C also. The same is repeated by B, but B is giving 25% of his chocolate, and the same is repeated by C, where C is giving his 50% chocolates. One needs to find out what can be the maximum number of chocolate or maximum percentage of chocolate with someone. Okay, so here you can try to maximize A first, okay, then you try to maximize B, and then you try to maximize C. The person whom you are trying to maximize, make sure that the others can give their full contribution to that person. That way you will be able to maximize the person. Okay, so there are three iterations which are involved here. and probably the concept might not strike you that directly. Then this question was based on surds and indices where x was equal to 5 plus under root 5. So first you need to take 5 on the left hand side, so you get x minus 5 is equal to root 5. You have to square it, and then again you have to square it to get into x raised to 4. Okay, but again you won't get the same coefficient in all the terms, so somewhere you have to subtract one equation from the other to be able to match the coefficients here. A question on linear equation where 95 items were supposed to be purchased for 1050, and the prices of items were 5 rupees, 11 rupees and 15 rupees. Okay, one need to maximize the number of items that can be bought of the costliest variety. So the number of 15 rupee item were to be maximized. Now the concept is simple here, that if you want to maximize the 15 rupee item, then you need to minimize the number of 5 rupee and 11 rupee items, right? But simultaneously you also need to ensure the integral values for the remaining two, and that makes the question really really tricky as well as time consuming. The next question was based on numbers where we had to find out remainder of 2020 raised to 2021 divided by 221. So this particular question will demand everything. It will demand you to apply Euler. It will also demand you to apply Chinese remainder theorem. Okay, so if you know both these concepts, you can go ahead and try this question. The next question was based on calendars, where it was given that sum of three consecutive days is a multiple of 34. Now, one combination that can strike readily in your mind is that 16, 17 and 18. Okay, sum of 16 plus 17 plus 18 is 51, which is a multiple of 17. Okay, it has to be multiple of 17 and not 34. Okay, please ignore that part. So sum of 16, 17, 18 is 51, and that is multiple of 17. So this particular combination will obviously satisfy, right? But there is one more combination towards the end of the month, which is 31 plus 1 plus 2. Remember, 31st plus 1st plus 2nd. These are also sum of three consecutive days, okay? And the summation is 34, which is a multiple of 17. Okay, now this combination might be satisfied only for the months which are having 31 days. So it should not be, you know, taken for all the months. Also, in a calendar year, this event has to happen. Okay, so you should not be counting December also, because from December to January, the calendar year will change. So this is really an intelligent piece of question mapping, I would say, right? Next question was based on chords and polygons. Wherein a quadrilateral was given, the midpoints were located, you connect the midpoints, you create a parallelogram inside it. Now the diagonals of this parallelogram are perpendicular to each other, so eventually it results into a rhombus, and then you had to find out the perpendicular distance from the vertex of the outer quadrilateral to the side of the rhombus. Okay, so this perpendicular distance can be calculated equating the area of the opposite triangle. Now this is a new concept to most of the students, and that is why you might not be able to solve this question unless and until you know about it. So that's why I'm putting it under difficult. Now based on this analysis of question classification, this is what we reach at. We discussed three easy questions, and you should have taken all three of them, right? Out of 7 moderate questions, again we are expecting you to solve most of them, so 6 can be the expected attempts over here. Out of the questions which are moderate but time consuming, remember they are moderate questions, okay? So one can still try at least 50% of these questions, which is 3 out of 5 can be solved. Difficult questions, we really don't want you to solve a lot of questions from this, but again, while you are, you know, in a selection process, you might come across one or two such questions which you could have taken. Okay, so out of 26 questions in total, the total number might be 22 here. Okay, there is a correction, pardon this. So out of total number of 22 questions, we expect you to solve around 14 questions as per this analysis, and if you maintain 85% accuracy over here, that results into 12 questions being correct, 2 being incorrect, which gives you 36 positive, 2 negative. So 34 is my ideal score for 98th percentile. And based on this analysis, you can see the highlighted part here. 34 is 98th percentile. 99 and 100 will be respectively at 38 marks and 45 marks. And yes, as I said earlier, if you are still not into this range of 80 to 100 percentile, okay, if you haven't yet made an entry, it is very easy to do it this time. You just have to get 6 net correct, because at 6 net correct you can get 6 into 3, 18 marks, which will be easily 81 to 82 percentile. Okay, so 80 percentile is at 16, 90 percentile is at 23, and 95 percentile is kept at 28. This is the quant section analysis, and let us come to overall analysis also. So if you look at the overall sectional as well as percentile, this is how it looks like. Now, you must have seen the section wise analysis for DILR and VARC already. So let us talk about the last column only. 80 percentile overall can be at 48. Now 48 is once again 16 net correct out of 66 questions. Okay. 90 percentile is capped at 58 overall score, 95 is at 69. Our ideal score 98 percentile will be at an overall score of 83, 99 is at 88, and 100 percentile is at 121. This particular paper you must have found on a low scoring side compared to the last 2 to 3 papers. Okay, but here we don't want students to draw the conclusion that the exacts are always like this and the exacts are always difficult. It's the first exact that you have seen here. Okay, so keep working, keep pushing yourself harder and harder. Okay, all the best for the upcoming test. Thank you very much.